Welcome back this morning. It has been 6 months now since coronavirus was first discovered in the U.S., the first case right here in Washington. Since then, we've seen close to 47,000 COVID-19 cases in our state, and more than 1,400 people have died because of the virus. And this morning, we are joined live by the Associate Director of Virology Labs at UW, Dr. Alex Greninger. Sir, thank you for being with us. Can you hear us?
Yeah, thanks for having me.
You betcha, in the age of Zoom. Glad you're with us here this morning. You know, we first spoke to you shortly after COVID-19 was confirmed back in January. Just curious, what have you learned since then about this new virus?
Yeah, so I remember that 6 months ago I was on the air with you guys. And I think it's been so driven by different analogies initially. You know, I remember we first talked about the original SARS coronavirus. And, you know, in that case, by the time that there was information out to the World Health Organization, it was 3 months and we really never saw it again. And I think what's thrown everyone for a loop here is really just that pre-symptomatic transmission. That is a feature that is shared among many viruses that are highly successful in spreading themselves among people. You know, in a way, HIV does a little bit of pre-symptomatic transmission in some ways. And herpes viruses, some of the viruses that have, you know, been really the most vexing for people. And so this one has been, in that way, that's really what's caught us. We have a real hard time knowing who to test and how to stop transmission when you have this pre-symptomatic transmission. And so that's, you know, what the main feature that's really changed in that time. I mean, from a scientific side, you're seeing all kinds of every scientist throwing their best approach. We know every host protein that this virus interacts with. We know it's, you know, receptor tropism. We have understanding of all the single amino acid variants that can help it out. We just have so much information. Unfortunately, those discoveries take a long time to translate. And the things that we've seen accomplished in the last few months are things where the work was done almost 7 or 8 years ago, like remdesivir, where it was someone who was specifically looking for drugs that would work against SARS coronaviruses as early as 2012, 2010. Hmm. And so we've booked those sort of gains. We've also got the steroid trials as well. And then now it's off the vaccines, of which we have many, many candidates.
You know, there's a lot that we don't know about this virus because it's new, Dr. Greninger. So we're learning a lot day by day, and certainly over the last 6 months. What about testing? What have we learned about people who have been tested negative, who then end up positive, and then vice versa?
Yeah. So, I mean, originally, I mean, in the beginning of March, we learned testing is very important. I mean, it helps protect our healthcare workers. It helps you identify. You really couldn't entirely tell this virus from other viruses. It's going to be fever, cough, shortness of breath. So testing is important. I think that said, testing has kind of gone into a different realm now. I mean, we're doing 800,000 tests a day in the country. Just in our clinical lab, we're doing more than 7,000, 8,000 tests a day. Basically, every 2 days, we test for this virus at a similar level as our highest volume virus we would test for all of last year. It's a really incredible volume, and it's hard for the system to keep up. And if you still have that pre-symptomatic transmission, it's hard to know exactly who to test. I think the thing we've learned about testing is that, you know, our tests can be very sensitive. And so, you know, we can find virus in people's noses. It's probably not even infectious, but we can find that for 8 to 12 weeks after symptom onset. And so you've seen actually just in the last couple of days, the CDC has sort of tried to change some of their criteria about returning people to work or getting people out of the hospital for something that's not so testing geared. So I think, you know, I think there's been there's so much. It's hard for testing. I think the U.S. has actually looked to see testing to solve this virus and sometimes forgotten about some of the other public health approaches that work, you know, like mask wearing, which we're now sort of, you know, doing on a larger scale basis. But also some of that just really, really hunkering down on the social distancing, which is actually what stops the transmission. Testing, you know, stops the transmission to some degree. But some of the studies have shown, you know, 40 to 50% of transmissions occur in that pre-symptomatic phase. And even if you're getting people tested who are symptomatic, they often wait like 4, 5, 6 days after symptoms because it takes a while for someone to realize, hey, this is something. And so it's, you know, I think that testing's ability to stop transmission is sometimes a little overstated, honestly. We need to focus on the things that actually stop transmission.
And Doc, we've got just a few quick seconds left with you, but it's always about the vaccine. Moderna, AstraZeneca are both just on a mad dash to the finish line to get a vaccine for everybody, really record setting. Real quick, what is your opinion about a vaccine by the end of the year?
I think we'll get there. I think one thing is we've never done this before. We've never made a successful vaccine for coronaviruses, so it's really hard to have a perfect opinion that way. That said, we're seeing, you know, great antibody responses. We're seeing T cell responses. I mean, these things look really good so far. And so, you know, it looks very promising, getting multiple shots on goal. Unfortunately, we're having a lot of cases in the United States, so these trials will enroll very quickly. We'll be able to get endpoints, which has been something that's been hard to do for other vaccines, is the virus just runs away from you. And so you don't actually get to finish the trial very quickly. So I'm optimistic.
Dr. Alex Greninger from the University of Washington, thank you so much for joining us this morning and giving us an update and for your expertise over the last 6 months. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks, Doc.